me the main room.
Whiskers!
Well, did you know that Whiskers has disappeared?
A cat got out. I'm trying to get it in.
We don't know how he got out. I think he got out in that hole.
No, I knew they were coming.
I think he got out in that hole. He could jump up there.
They were coming tonight.
No, he got out of that hole, he did.
I put them all out. You told me to.
No, he got out of the hole.
Take the cats out, you said.
Did you hear what I said, woman?
What?
He got out this hole here. That was the noise we heard. The raccoon did that to my new hole. Isn't that terrible? They'll have the whole house down soon.
Yeah, we'll be raided again. We'll be raided again by the village of East Hampton. You know, they can get you in East Hampton for wearing red shoes on a Thursday and all that sort of thing. I don't know whether you know that. I mean, do you know that? They can get you for almost anything. Mr. Maysles.
Hi, Edie.
The gentleman called us.
I saw your car. One of my cats just
Edie,
jumped out.
Edie, you look fantastic.
David, you look absolutely terrific, honestly. You've got light blue on. Well, Al, you're still, Mother says you're very conservative. Brooks, everything looks wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. This is the best thing to wear for today, you understand?
Yeah.
Because I don't like women in skirts, and the best thing is to wear pantyhose or some pants under a short skirt, I think. Then you have the pants under the skirt, and then you can pull the stockings up over the pants underneath the skirt.
Mm-hmm.
And you can always take off the skirt and use it as a cape. So I think this is the best costume for today.
Okay.
I have to think these things up, you know. Mother wanted me to come out in a kimono, so we had quite a bite.
So what did you do, photograph Brooks cutting right down here?
Yeah, I've been through the jungle.
Oh, for goodness sake. What do you want to do now? Where do you want to go? Upstairs? You want to go up on and photograph it from the top porch?
Okay.
Okay.
They're going to photograph from the top now, Brooks.
Beautiful garden back here.
You see the wall garden?
Oh, you mean the patio?
Yeah.
You mean this? Oh, that's a Spanish wall garden.
Where's
over
that?
There, you
oh.
know.
Oh, yeah.
The Hills put that in. They imported everything from Rome. Mrs. Hill, she was a famous horticulturist. That was one of the famous gardens of America. Brooks, next summer for all living, I think a vegetable garden would be a good thing in here.
We're getting enough sunlight in here.
Yeah, Mother says she doesn't mind if you have to cut down some privet for the garden.
It'd be nice.
Yeah. Because food's going up. We heard that on the radio last night. Do you think my costume looked all right for Brooks? I think he was a little amazed.
He's probably seen it before.
No. This is the revolutionary costume. I never wear this in East Ham.
He seems okay. He seems like he can handle it.
You can't You know what I mean?
That was the original living room. You know, people go back to a kitchen now. Though the washing machine was always put in the maid's dining room. You know, the wash tubs are in the maid's dining room.
Let's go up.
It's very difficult to keep the line between the past and the present. Do you know what I mean? It's awfully difficult.
It is a beautiful ocean today, isn't it? What color would you say that was, sort of sapphire? I've never seen anything like that ocean. The 50 years I've been here, the best in 50 years.
Oh, Edie, are you around? Oh, Edie!
Damn horrible place in 2 years. God, if you knew how I felt, I'm ready to kill.
Well,
Brooks wants his... check, mother darling.
Oh,
he's at the door.
I told you I should do it now.
$24 for 3 cuttings. Just a minute.
You better bring the pen.
I locked all the cats away.
Don't be so mean. They don't want to be locked away, the poor little kitties. You know kitties. Door, son.
I suppose I won't get out of here till she dies or I die.
Who is she?
I don't know when I'm going to get out of here.
Well, why do you want to get out? Another place would be
much worse.
Because
I don't like it.
Any place would be much worse. Any place on earth.
Yeah, but I like freedom.
Well, you can't get it, darling. You're being supported. You can't get any freedom when you're being supported.
You can't.
No, you can't.
I think you're not free when you're not being supported.
You have to tell them off.
It's awful both ways, huh?
Well, you don't look it. You look very young for 56 years of age. Don't you remember what you told me?
I know, I just like a couple of days on
the
beach.
What was it you told me?
That's all. $24.
You don't have to scream that out. When are you going to learn, Edie? You're in this world, you know. You're not out of the world. See if I can remember the date. Is it the 12th today?
Well, there are certain compensations, I guess.
Is it the 12th today? The old woman, she has to remember everything, you know. I think this is correct.
Brooks Hires. H-I-E-R-S.
Oh, I didn't think it was necessary.
Yes.
Why don't you let me do this in the house for? Why do you make me do it here?
Well, you don't have enough clothes on.
Well, I hope I'm going to get naked in just a minute, so you better watch out.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Yeah, for what? Now, why? I haven't got any warts on me.
But the movie.
I haven't got any warts on me.
That isn't the point, mother darling.
Oh, yeah, you know where you got, being like that. No husband, no babies, nothing.
Well, I can't help it. I like to wear certain things.
Is that H-Y-E-R-S?
She likes everything.
H-Y?
Without girdles.
H-Y, Edie? Or H-I?
H-Y-E-R-S.
H-Y?
Yes. Yeah. She and Marjorie McQuillan don't believe in wearing girdles.
I haven't worn a girdle since I was 12
David.
Years old. Here you
Mother
are.
Mother has certain ideas about death.
Certainly have certain
about
ideas
clothes.
About living a long time. Well, I got ideas about... Very hard to live nowadays. Living is very difficult.
The Libra husband is not an easy man to please. The monotony of domesticity is not to his liking, but he is a passionate man and a respecter of tradition. All I have to do is find this Libra man. The Libra husband is reasonable. He is a born judge, and no other zodiacal type can order his life with so much wisdom. God, that's all I need, order. That's all I need, an ordered life. You know, a manager. But he's got to be a Libra.
Hello?
Yeah?
No, that's Jerry.
Oh, is that Jerry? For goodness sake.
How do you know?
Jerry, you're Aquarius, aren't you?
Yeah.
That's what I saw when I met you, Jeremy. Remember I said the marble fawn? It was terrible. Terrible, the tragedy connected with the marble fawn. You know, I called Jerry the marble fawn.
Nathaniel Hawthorne.
Yeah. You have that book here, Edie?
I haven't been able to find it.
If you run across it, I'd like to read it.
It's very deep. I don't know whether you... Well, I guess you're up to it. They used to have it on all the, I think it was on the high school reading list. Marble form. The Libra husband does not seek divorce unless the conditions of his life are not adjustable. I don't believe in divorce at all. I think divorce...
Was your mother divorced? No. Separated.
Yes, and then my father got a fake Mexican divorce, and he did have, you know, what he called another wife that we didn't recognize. It wasn't recognized by the Catholic Church. They don't recognize it, you know.
Say, are you bossing me around, Edie, all afternoon?
I think that's terrific.
Oh, Edie, it's not the best one. This is the worst one of my wedding pictures.
The others look worse.
I was going to be a singer, you know, a professional singer. And I met Mr. Beale, the jig was up.
You remember this?
May I see that, please?
Dawn of the Peace. To my best friend and most delightful comrade, to my only sweetheart and wonderful wife, I tender this likeness of her husband, Beale and Beale, 1929.
But we did love each other.
Did I laugh when I read that? Aren't kids terrible? I just roared. And the people don't speak. They never get divorced. Yeah, you just can't tell.
I've been a very happy woman all my life.
Shall I tell them about Gould?
Gould was Mother's accompanist. He was a boogie-woogie composer who had the most terrific style.
He was the most brilliant man I've ever met. That's including Mr. Beale and Mr. Bouvier. Completely brilliant.
This cute, Mother. Well, oh, I've got very much, don't you, David?
You said you said Michelle Beale stole this, didn't you?
He never did. She never did.
See how fine I look?
He did.
Did I look like a good mother? Was I a good mother?
Looks like it.
I didn't starve my children, did I? Why?
Fed them well.
They were very nice children. I enjoyed them tremendously. I'm crazy about my two sons. Absolutely mad about them.
Who's the little girl?
That's Meg.
Well, the boys were not hard handled. Boy, that was very easy to
do. Oh, my mother never saw my brothers.
Saw them every minute, every single
day. Oh, they never got any discipline, my brothers.
They didn't need it. They were absolutely perfect. We were taken with a tiny little Kodak number two. That was. Kodak number two cost $2, I can't.
Mother, I'm mad about these pictures of you.
Oh, no, don't take those.
I want them.
Will you give me those, please?
No, can't.
No, I want them, Edie. I will never see them again. No. I want those pictures. I want those pictures, Edie.
Can't expose them to the light.
No, you give me those pictures. Oh, and I don't want to ask 67 times. Come on.
I want to show that to Al.
Oh, no, I want to show
I want to show
picture.
It to Al.
My picture.
Look what you made me do.
Well, you did it.
Al.
Look what you did.
Classical face. I want you to
look
see
at what
this.
You did. Look.
Very few that. People have this, Al. I want you to see this. Now look. This is my mother. There's British blood, maybe Jewish. I don't know. Dean of family, not sure.
I don't want that photo.
Scotch blood. The
Ewing. Imagine showing all those horrible things
clan,
that I don't want to show.
The Ewing clan's in there. But it's just a girl from a good French family. It's a very beautiful face.
I lived alone these 30 years. I didn't know. Get very independent when you live alone. Get to be a real individual.
You can't have your cake and eat it.
Oh, yes, I did.
In life.
I did. I had my cake, loved it, masticated it, chewed it, and had everything
you can't
I
your
wanted.
Cake and eat it too.
I had a very, very happy, satisfying life.
When you had a rich husband, you should have stayed with him. Now you might as well face it. She was bored. She couldn't stand.
Well, I was not. I was a great singer. I had a perfect marriage. Beautiful children. Terribly successful marriage. Never had a fight in my life.
I never threw anything, Mr. Beale. Never. They threw the bull around, as they say. No, I never had any words with Mr. Beale at all. I came down here to live in this house because I did all my singing here. I was so happy. I was happier going out and singing than anything I've ever done since I was born. I liked it better than anything I ever did.
I can't find it, woman. You let me help you. Listen, kid. I'm extremely organized. I know exactly where to look for this stuff. I got it under control right here, but I can't find it. Get it?
Well, bring in the orchestration of T for Two.
I can't do it, my feet hurt.
Just try, babe. They're beautiful.
I have to get my voice exactly back the way it was when I was 45 years old.
You can't, Mother.
Yes, I can.
Something happens. Let's face it.
I never strained my voice ever in my life.
Oh, I strained my voice. I'm yelling and screaming. Cigarettes. What is the matter?
Oh, no.
I can never speak it.
Why, get it back in about a month. It's about it. You know, good hard work.
We are together. Gould and Mother made this record in 1934. He was Mother's accompanist.
Cadenza.
Could I be in love? Do you want that? Aren't you mad about your record?
I was very serious about my singing. Loved it.
After you hear that, you realize nothing is
important.
No, it isn't. Nothing.
Well, my mother, you know, she gave me the right slant on my voice. She told me to leave everything.
No man could compete against Mrs. Beale and Gould.
We were pretty
no good. Man in the world.
Well? I worked hard. I wish you would play lower. I think.
Imagine bothering about anything when she had a talent like that.
Well, I'd take care of this house. I lived on no money.
You were able to save the house on account of me.
Yeah, I think.
I didn't want to live in East Hampton, but I had to on account of Mother's house.
Well, now you see why you lived, because you had music all the time. That's why. And you went to the beach too. That's what you like.
Yeah, those are the only things.
Well, I think you liked your dancing. You were very good at that.
This is costing a lot.
Did you see the play on Broadway?
No, ma'am.
T for two, and two for T, and me for you, and you for me. Hello? Hear us to see us or hear us, no friends or relations on weekend vacations. You won't have it known, dear, that we own a telephone, no. I'll awake and start to bake a sugar cake for you to take, for all the boys to see. A family, a girl for you, a boy for me. Oh, can't you see how happy we could be? Tea for two. Edie's any good, the soft shoe now. She's any good at all. It's all soft shoe now, you know. This is a dance. Come on, Edie. I used to do it myself, you know. I did that, the soft shoe. See us or hear us, no friends or relation. On weekend vacation, they won't have it known, dear, that we own a telephone. No, 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 but I'll wake and start to bake a shook, shook, sugar cake, cake, cake. Z for all the birds to see.
Dancing?
No.
I do terrific dances. I only care about three things, the Catholic Church, swimming, and dancing. But I had to give them up. I've got enough. I almost died with the fleas in this place. I can't go on another year. I have to get to a hotel room.
Well, I bought a lot of stuff for your fleas, and I'll be more than willing to put it down.
All I want is a little room. I can't stand a concrete house. First place, it makes me terribly nervous. Scared to death of doors, locks, people roaming around in the background, under the trees, in the bushes. I'm absolutely terrified. I'm not a bit terrified of the city. Not a bit. I like the terrible noise you hear at night and all these terrible drilling sounds. I never go to sleep unless the whole pavement is jumping outside. And it's 100 degrees, and that drill is just going, and then I just go to sleep. I only hope it stays up. The balalaika. I haven't got my makeup. I feel something slipping. What am I missing?
We'll almost have to listen to Peel in about 5 seconds.
She doesn't like the Catholic Church. She gets very mad right now.
What the hell? I worship the Catholic Church. Mm-hmm. I'm going to invite Father Huntington over to spend the whole entire night with me. That's what I'm going to do. I love the church so much. Here it is.
To get on top of things and to stay there.
Does that mean women too?
Or if you do not do this, it is very likely that things will get on top of you.
Isn't he terrific?
And since I always believe in a simple formula that is workable, I have a formula for you now. First, try, really try.
Try, really try.
Second, think. Really think.
Cute, think, really.
And third, believe. Really believe. Well, you may say, how many times do I have to try? Well, it may be a good many times. For example, I have in my pocket here a letter from a man in London, England. Dear Dr. Peel, over 3 years ago, I was in your great marble collegiate church for the first time, and I was having it rough. The job I'd been doing had come to an end, and I was 55.
What?
Your significant lived with me, plus the advice to try, really try, really think, believe, really believe. I did think, I did work very hard. hard to find a job. 88 interviews. So did he or did he not get the job?
He did.
Will he or will he not handle himself in the years that are to come? He wasn't emotional. He didn't get upset. He wasn't nervous.
It wasn't me.
He was cool. Now, one thing is sure. The human mind will not function when it is hot. Only when it is cool and dispassionate.
That's the word I wanted the other day. I couldn't think of what it was.
I think it would be a good idea if every day, every individual would look at himself in the mirror earnestly and ask the question, who am I? Am I a weak person? Am I a defeated person? Am I an inferior person? Not at all. I am a child of God, and I was intended to get on top of things, and I was intended to stay there.
Very good. That was very long. Very long.
And I was having my on and on and on. Let's hear the prayer. You sing the song now.
Doc Zellman.
Sing it. You have been listening to Dr. Norman Vincent Peale as he spoke this morning from his...
No emotionalism. Never give up. You want to keep on top. Way high up on top. Wonderful way to smother somebody.
Did you pass your mirror over here? I've got to see what I look like.
Don't drop it.
I'm telling
you. That was wonderful.
I see why. Yeah. I got cataracts. I have astigmatism, one eye pulled against the other, and I should have worn glasses, and I didn't.
Oh, I told you to wear glasses.
Is there anything else you want to know?
You got me the glasses about 4 years ago.
I'll tell you about my teeth.
4 years ago, Edie, you got the glasses. You didn't wear them.
My teeth are still on.
You have to wear glasses when you have any trouble. You have to.
And my hair will grow, I hope, here.
Dress for battle, Edie.
Mother's telling Marjorie how spoiled I am, how terrible I am. And Marjorie knew my father and my uncle. Mother's giving her all this S-H-I-T, so I went and told them things about the family. But you see, in dealing with me, the relatives didn't know that they were dealing with a staunch character. And I tell you, if there's anything worse than a staunch woman, S-T-A-U-N-C-H.
There's nothing worse, I'm telling you. They don't weaken, no matter what. But they didn't know that.
How would they to know?
You know, my father'd made up his mind about what Farmington produced, what the Sacred Heart Convent produced. I don't think he was so down on the Spence School. He certainly was down on Farmington. I don't know why. Farmington was a junior college. You could choose what you wanted to study. Perhaps that was what made my father dislike it so, that I could choose. But I chose what I thought he'd want me to choose. You know, English literature and Oriental philosophies and... I always took French, but nothing ever happened there. I can read and write in French, but I can't speak it. I had years and years and years of French. Terrible.
This was taken by Amy DuPont, but my last year in Farmington. I was 17.
Edie, that's so beautiful.
Mr. Wainwright did that. He was an artist from a very good family. He was in the social register. He did it in the solarium of Grey Gardens.
Dave, look at this.
I was at a fashion show.
Let me see that.
Oh,
huh?
Beautiful. Look at that
thing.
May I see that?
Wow, look at the
fur. I thought it was the cat's pajamas in that.
Let me see it, Edie. See how pretty Edie was when she was young? It's perfectly foolish of her not to look that way now. She could, you know, she didn't worry about everything. And she looked like a girl that had everything,
This is inspired me. I should get another brown tailored suit and grow my hair.
You know,
my God! I have no hair.
Never put any lipstick on for this picture, did you?
Have another kind.
You look horrible. Why didn't you put lipstick and makeup on?
Mr. Beale smashed the window of Bert Bachrock when he put this in the window on Upper Madison Avenue.
For God's sake.
He offered me a job. He didn't say to get out of that family situation, but he said, you need a job, Miss Beale.
Didn't you expect that Edie might get married someday?
Oh, I did. I wanted to. Oh, I picked out some nice men. She didn't like the men I picked out.
You were horrible.
She could have married this Gerald Geddes. He was a millionaire, gave her a gorgeous ring. She decided not to marry that guy. She had to give the ring back. It went awful. She had a proposal of marriage from Paul Geddes. Remember Paul, the richest man in the world?
He married Teddy Lynch.
Then you could have married Jordan McClanahan. He was another millionaire. He wanted to marry you. She just didn't want to get married. That's all blamed on me.
No, I never fell in love when I was 31.
Well, how old are you in these pictures?
24.
24, that old?
1940.
Very young looking, but 24.
Yeah. France had just fallen to Hitler.
But you never fell for a man.
Paris, excuse me.
France fell, but Edie didn't fall.
That was the thing. See, they didn't tell us that when we studied World War I, that everything was so awful with the Versailles Treaty, that we were soon going to get into something 4 years after I got out. If I'd only known it, I would have just enjoyed every single minute, just done everything.
It must have been tough for people. I remember as a kid, so many loved ones being killed. But you were the dating age.
A lot of my friends went overseas and got married. They went in the Red Cross. They went to India or Australia. They all got married. One of my best friends went to Australia. If I'd been able to go, she might have persuaded me to go with her. And she met somebody in the hospital. She was working for the Red Cross, and she never came back to New York. But I never had a chance to do anything like that because Mother wasn't well during the war. She had her eye operation.
I missed out on everything. I missed out on the reunion of my graduating class in Farmington because that was the fall that Jack Kennedy campaigned to get in. And I was stuck here with Mother, the cast, the house, and T. Logan. And I couldn't go.
No, you said you didn't want them to know how old you were, you said.
No, I think
I didn't want them to know my age, says Edie.
No, I would have enjoyed that, Mother, because Jack Kennedy campaigned to get in and won.
Get in the Farmington school? That'd be a good place for him.
I don't know. I think it would have been a lot of fun.
Yeah, everything's good that you didn't do. At the time, you didn't want it.
I couldn't get away.
Well, that's the choice. You can't go back and say, feel gorgeous right now. And say, why didn't I do this?
Leave.
Because you didn't feel then the way you do now. Everybody thinks and feels differently as the years go by, don't they?
Yeah.
What time is it, chickens?
What time is it? It's,
I want to go
1:30.
I may need David's hand to get up.
You have it.
Where is it? Can you come around this way?
Sure.
Are you taking pictures?
Always.
Yeah.
Two roads diverged in yellow wood, and pondering one, I took the other, and that made all the difference.
Robert Frost.
Isn't that wonderful?
Did he say that?
That's all you need, just three lines like
that. Come on, is that Robert Frost?
Who else? Two roads.
I think you're poor.
Diverged in yellow wood.
Come on, you said that. We want something
and
else.
And pondering one, I took the other.
You're not teaching
and
us.
And that made all
we
the difference.
We don't want to learn it. It's very pretty.
Isn't that amazing?
No, I don't think it's half as good as your poem.
They look the same, and he probably couldn't tell, and yet he... I wish I could remember the correct line.
exhausted. I danced 8 hours last night practicing the marching song.
Right.
My God, my muscles, I can't do it. I'm telling you, what am I gonna do? They're gone with this sort life. We all march together for love is mine. We all stand together, united we die. All march together for we love the land. It's the spirit of the AMI. We all march together for life is mine. When they do that, that's when the plane goes by, see? So I'm doing the VMI marching song, which is a ground maneuver. Anyway, I gotta get it all coordinated in my mind.
Hey, Mother, I'm working on my kids!
Why? You see, she doesn't want to eat any more for about that, so I have to sit in and starve all the time.
How can I eat? I think
I lost. I lost 5 pounds. Well, don't live with me. I want to eat. Will you eat some liver pate? You can't.
It's not awfully good.
It is. You put lemon with it, so.
I may die with this diet. I don't like it at all.
Don't do it. Have a sandwich.
I got fat not wearing clothes for 2 years.
Oh, that wasn't in it. Oh, it was the quarts and quarts of ice cream. My bill was $171 just for ice cream.
Here's your little liver.
You have to make it. I can't do it. No, I can't. I ate in front of the Maysles the other day. You have to make it. I was very embarrassed. No. I ate all that chicken.
Oh, Mother, I should have stolen that blue.
Take it out, babe. You like the green? That's your drawer, is there.
What do I do with these?
You have crackers somewhere.
I put on crackers.
Yeah, you should. It needs a lemon or mayonnaise or something.
When am I going to get out of here?
Oh, she's always talking like that.
I mean, you're never going to get me back to East Hampton.
Oh, that's
ever.
Oh, Edie, that is.
Never.
Edie, the man is doing this, for goodness sake. That's terrible.
Brother, I'm not ever.
Well, you got
back
an awful trouble there. It's a good thing you had a place to come to. Recuperated Mama's for about 15-20 years. She had a horrible time. I used to have to send her big boxes of groceries. She was starving. For my grossest thing.
I was discovered.
A big box of groceries.
I need a treat.
And I always put a bottle of wine in a bag. I thought she'd have a terrible accident.
I was discovered, but...
Oh, I wouldn't say anything good happened to you in New York.
Are you kidding?
No.
I was discovered by Mr. Gould.
Okay.
He was a friend of Mrs.
Well, what is it?
People
discover me every time I go out, but I don't think anything of it.
He went to pieces, Mr. Max Gordon, when I was
born. Not Max Gordon. He never went to pieces in his life.
He
did not. Very
now, what was the woman's name? She gave you the letter. Mrs. Hitchcock.
I can't go back to ancient history. How can you remember so long? Now I'll have to get drunk, Edie. I'll have to start drinking. I can't take it. She'll make a drunkard out of a mother.
What crackers do you want? We'll take these. Do you mind? They're very good. Do you want these?
I don't like crackers, you know that. Just put a lemon on it, a little lemon.
Don't you know who Max Gordon is? He's a famous producer. You've heard of him, haven't you? Discovered Judy Holliday, or
Holliday.
He discovered Judy Holliday. He said I was much funnier.
You haven't been funny today, boy. You're racking in humor. It's how you are when you grow older.
I needed training. Where was I to get the training?
You start when you're 12. I had mine when I was 12.
This crack is for the photographer. Tell me what I should have done.
Here, would you put this away, please, Edie?
I should have immediately tried to get into something.
That gets frozen, will you?
David?
God,
instead of coming home, I should have tried to get into something. Is that it? You think I should have gotten
David,
in?
Do you think you and your
nightclub
now
work,
should have
David,
told me need to lose weight? You've been in
do you think I should have gotten into nightclub work?
And
here's another thing.
I had
my father was alive. That was it. My father was alive.
I was going around with a
that my father was alive.
You want to hear what I had to say?
Mr. Beale would have had me committed.
Gould and I want Edie every day to go to Trapagan. She could do anything. She could learn toe dancing. She could learn radio. She could learn all sorts of stage dancing.
Why would
she
could dance?
The things we told you to go to Bendel's and
I'm going to go with my mother sitting here.
Model earring. You had to
go with my mother sitting here.
And you were so gorgeous in hats, and you had such a beautiful face. And we always adored you, and you said, she could do hats, and she had gorgeous feet. And Mr. Beale always made her wear a certain kind of shoe when she was a little girl, orthopedic shoe. And she
had a deep responsibility for you, Mother.
I was taking care of her.
The hallmark of aristocracy is responsibility. Is that it? I can't spend another winter out here in the country. I can't do it. I don't enjoy it. Furthermore, I'm telling you, I can't get my figure back unless I hit New York City. You know, that ice box is too near. I've got to get away from that ice box.
Place for you. Get on the stage in Paris at the Folie Bergère.
Yeah, but the point is that I came down here to take care of my mother. I was sick and tired of worrying about her night and day.
Well, I had a very good man.
I was away from her for 5 years.
I had a very good man.
And I was sick and tired of
lying
awake
at night. I had a very good man to take care of me. You know, he took care of me.
Wondering what was happening to my mother.
For 25 years, she didn't have to worry.
Who was the man that took care of you for 25 years?
23 Nobody years. Took care of her for 25 years. I took care of this damn house for 25 years.
I think Al was...
Dare say my mother was ever taken care of by any man but my father, and I'll push you under the goddamn bed.
No, Edie, I think Al was referring to Gould.
Yes, he was. He took care of mother by accompanying her to the movies and playing the piano.
Took care of me and the washing.
No one took care of Mrs. Beale. She had my father's money and her own money, the Bouvier money. And another thing, Mrs. Beale wasn't taken care of sexually.
I think he was nicer than anybody I've ever known my whole life. He was a writer. He wrote 7 books at one time. He was brilliant. And he played the piano magnificently and composed exquisite music and dedicated about 80 songs to me.
So Edie didn't have to take
care
of
you. No, she didn't have to worry the way she did. No.
She made me leave the Barbizon.
Well, I thought you'd been in New York long enough. You were getting lines in your face.
I didn't want to leave. I was getting my big chance.
Oh, no, you were not. That married man was not going to give you any chance at all. You were not.
I was going to get it.
Well,
Well, you didn't get it. You missed out.
I was just getting up what you call
now,
a little
you're wasting that thing on this, because it's just nuts.
When she said I had to come
home. Well, I thought you should come home.
Well, anyway, she started my question for me to come back in March of 1952, and she kept it up until the end of July, July 29th.
Well,
I checked out, got on the train, came back, and was never able to get back.
It's very hot in New York on July 29th.
You know that one?
Hmm.
You do know it?
Sure.
Sing it for me.
Sing. The night was young and your
soul. No, you and the night and the music. Sing that song.
I don't know that. I thought you
knew it.
You and the night and the music.
He knows it. It's gone.
I don't know the rest of it.
Fill me with flaming desire. The words are wonderful. Love like yours and mine is a glowing thrill of sparkling wine. Make the most of time ere it has flown. You're the night and the music. Thrill me with flaming desire, setting my being completely on fire. Oh, you and the night and the music, dance till the music is through. I forgot. Oh, listen, this is it, yes. Love. Till the moment is through. After the night and the music die, will I have you?
Where's Joe, Edie? Anyway,
I don't know, Mother. That's what I'm wondering.
Don't you think you better find him?
My mother wants me to watch him the whole time he's in the house.
No, you told me not to have him back here.
Like I watched Tom.
No, thanks.
My eyes dropped out. Mother and her friends. I never cared for the three people that my mother liked. I couldn't get on with Mr. Beale, and I didn't care for her composer friend. And as for Tom Logan, he drove me crazy in the house.
I love Tom. He played the guitar so beautifully. He sang, he was in Rodeo, and he even was in Hollywood. You'd have to admire somebody like that.
She was a pushover.
He had no
place
to go.
And then he asked my mother, he said, I've just been fired from the Sea Spray. Would you like a maintenance man? Mother took him home.
I didn't want a maintenance man. I said, I'll take you home for one night.
That's the story of
Tom
Logan.
There wasn't a thing he didn't know how to do. He could fix anything, lights. Plumber thing. He knew how to do everything. Sick one was a terribly clever man.
Did he work? He made good salads, but he was drunk.
Oh, no. He came up here every morning at 6 o'clock, knocked on my door. We talked over the menu for the day, including a half a bottle of rosé vin, or wine, whatever it's called.
Naturally, you couldn't get rid of him, and I had to stay here. What I should have done was leave, and he would have left.
Well, all right, you don't believe in religious compulsion. It was a religious thing.
If I'd left, he would have left.
No, and I deserve
it. Would have been too
well, he
much.
Didn't want to go.
All alone in the house for Tom.
He didn't.
All I had to do was leave. I'm so stupid that.
Well, where would I have been? I'd been all alone in the house.
I think you would have, Molly. Why? Marble Fawn is at the door. He can wait. Let Jerry in. Hurry up. I'm gonna look at this pad without Jerry. La da 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 da. La da dee da da. This is a sea of leaves. Complete sea of leaves. If you lose something, you can't find it again. It drops to the bottom.
I lost my scarf. I'll never get it again. Best scarf I ever owned, the most beautiful color blue. It dropped. You know, it fell off my head. The hell with the marbles. Hello?
Hello, Edie.
Oh, hello, Jerry, darling. Do you want to come in?
Yeah, I just came for the faucet so I can get right out to the hardware store.
Yeah, Mother said you called up. Was that you on the phone very early?
Yeah.
How are you? I'm looking at you now.
Really well.
I'll come down and let you in. Do you want to come up here? You want to come up?
All right, for a moment.
Mother's screaming to have me let you in. I better do it.
We'll be out the back door here, okay?
I'll come right down.
Jerry's puffing and blowing.
No, I'm tired. I don't want to get any tired.
What do you want, Jerry? Who wants a nice piece of corn?
No, I don't want any, thank you.
Jerry, you didn't get enough to eat tonight.
Well, I can't resist. I'm sorry.
I'm watching. Jerry, you're going to put some of this on, aren't you?
Yeah. You want to do it for me?
Why, yeah. Pleasure's all mine. I don't burn myself. Which piece of corn do you want, Jerry?
Doesn't matter.
See how polite he is. You want some, Edie? Where's your plate, Jerry?
I got very big hands. Corn, that is world.
Oh, did I do it nicely? He always compliments me on the way I do my corn.
There they are.
There, you raccoons. Run away from your drinks and do that to your raccoons.
Yeah, he's there.
Everything's in the attic. Everything from sloths, otters, badgers, possums, raccoons.
I don't need the bags anymore. Because I had to get up 200 cellophane bags. This, horrors. Somebody's removing the books from my room. Where did this little book come from?
No, Jerry hasn't knocked himself out.
He's around there. Who got this book out of my room?
I cleaned this whole
attic up the other day. Now, who's been dropping books around is what I want to know. I would have seen that book. We lost the glasses. The glasses are gone.
Next thing, those antiques will all be missing.
See, you shouldn't have a contact with the outside world, because how do I know that there isn't something up in that room? If you get what I mean. You can't tell what's been put up in that room or what's been taken out.
Don't worry so much, please. Cat's going to the bathroom. Right in back of my portrait.
God, isn't that awful?
No, I'm glad he is. I'm glad somebody's doing something they want to do. I was frozen this morning when I woke up. Are you eating?
It did drop.
I missed you last night.
Yeah, dropped quite a bit.
It was so lonely, she only left me one little kitty to keep me warm. And all these blankets were on the floor, all this pile of stuff here.
Jerry's pretty good waiting on me. He can find things here that I wouldn't find for half an hour.
Jerry the majordomo.
I'm so sick of that kid. I mean, I
no,
have great pity
you know
for him, and I like
Noah
him,
says,
but...
You know the trouble.
What?
The trouble is that he's madly in love with Edie. I said I thought Edie was madly in love with him on me.
He might as well leave right now, because he's never going to get it. So that's
it. Sex with you?
What he's after.
He doesn't want any sex with you.
Well, that's
old,
all they're after.
Old person like
that's
you?
That's all they're after. So why don't you tell him
unheard
right
of,
now?
Unheard of.
You should tell him right now,
well,
so I'm not bothered by it.
He's got about six girls in East Hampton. He's so busy.
No, but
every
the
night.
Point is, he thinks
what he was doing is out every single night with a different girl.
Yeah, but that's the point, you see.
He had a wonderful time.
He's going to be here for years and years.
He enjoyed himself thoroughly, I hope.
The guy's going to be here for years and years.
I doubt.
It's going to be one of those things, like Tom Logan.
Aren't you going to feed the Whiskers, Edie? Come on, go and feed Whiskers.
Now, don't eat it. Give it to Whiskers, please. We're fine. You want to get thin,
but
don't
she's
you?
Very mean to me.
No, I have to be very strict. The priest said she needed a very strict hand. Well, priest don't mean. She and his daughter needs a very strong hand, your daughter. Run. Tried to give it over after Mr. Beale, you know, stopped living in East Hampton. I had a terrible hard time. Edith, she just went wild after our father wasn't living here. It was wild. Absolutely wild. I couldn't do anything with it at all.
Isn't it awful when the dancer gets back? Isn't it awful? God, it's awful, I'm telling you. It's awful. God. My father believed in running the children's lives. You know, he wanted me to get my master's degree, be a junior partner in his law firm.
Take the ice cream.
He was 165 Broadway. On the ninth floor, my knees would start to shake.
Coming
down.
By
the time I got to the ninth floor in Mr. Beale's office, my knees were rattling, my mouth was dry.
You scared of your father.
And I'd go in and he'd come forward out of his office with his watch in his hand, and then he'd look at the clock on the wall and said, "You're 5 minutes late," he'd say. Oh my God.
No, he had a very
And then close. He'd sit down and he'd look at me on this and say, "Take it off! Take that hat off! Take that lipstick off! Take that nail polish off!
Oh,
how
no,
dare
no.
you wear
no,
those
she's
high heels?"
Acting all over the place.
Don't you want some of this?
Butter pecan.
He said the only thing to be was a professional woman. He did say that. Didn't he, Mom?
Well, I wouldn't say it's the only thing.
He didn't want me to get married.
I don't think people should get married. I don't believe in it at all.
If you can't get a man to propose to, you might as well be dead.
Well, I don't think it's important.
I think it's disgusting.
And Mary had the most wonderful life.
Absolutely disgusting.
Lived
to
be
women
94 years of age.
What are they proving? They have to go around with dogs or other women or something?
That dogs are lovely.
I was terrible.
I'll take a dog any day.
Why didn't you marry the man you wanted to like I did?
I think the saddest thing was my not marrying into the Obolensky family because I adore them. Eddie Obolensky is wonderful. That's all I can say.
Very sweet man.
He's related to the Obolenskys. He's okay.
I didn't know he was any relation to them.
Yes.
Never know.
Serge's nephew by his half-sister.
Now, there was a boy I might have married.
Why didn't you marry Paul Geddes?
And I said, how did you happen to come here? And he said, oh, I saw you at a dance, he said, in Southampton. I said, you did? He said, yeah.
He was just a kid.
He was 32. And I said, Eugene, what you need, a girl. And he said, no, Edith, I'm looking for a wife. He said, I want to get married. I thought
he wanted to take Edie to Westchester.
Wasn't that cute?
Tom had just died, and I did not want another man in my kitchen with
and
a cookbook.
And I went downstairs, I appeared
at just made
space.
A cookbook. You just written
and
a cookbook.
Mother got rid of him 15 minutes.
Don't want any cookbooks.
Mother got rid of him 15 minutes because he came from a celebrated family.
He was very glad
to meet. The Tiskevich family. And I suppose Mother didn't want me to have anybody that was decent.
I didn't want anybody in the kitchen.
It would have been perfectly all right for me to have married Tom Logan.
Why do you want to marry a kid 32?
Oh, I forgot to say that Eugene was a count.
Jeans.
I would have been Countess Edith.
I didn't want my child to be taken away. I've been entirely alone.
You know what I go through with this awful stuff? And I've got to be hungry. Well, you know me. You're always hungry. I'm not going to gain the weight back.
Put some lipstick on.
These are my brother's drawers, and I feel so strongly about my mental and everything because of Mother that I was never able to ever clean out these desk drawers and throw the stuff away. Would you believe that? You know, it's childhood stuff. What are they called? Memorabilia or something. I couldn't throw anything away. Now, looking at this room. Yeah, just a minute. They discovered something terrific in here. I don't know, is that Austria? I can't see. Why, what happened?
The moving finger writes and having written moves on. I was going to write another line from Omar Khayyam. We come like water and we go like wind.
Oh, I got that one up. That's the man, this is the woman. I can't tell.
Are you getting me to do it, Mommy?
I'm putting up the silver masks.
Hey, come here a minute, hurry.
I can't get the thumbtack in the wall. I got the saddest life. I could go on with the redecoration of this room. Yeah. All right. I made this. Those are roses of all different years. It's my shell collection. You can't see it, it's so dirty. Isn't that tragic? Then I have two little things to go there. And around the world's supposed to go there. I was going to put that up there because I like red in this room for some reason. Then I was going to hang the birdcage right here and have around the world there. But I haven't gotten to that.
Perhaps I better begin taking care of Mother and bossing her and cooking her some food. What do you boys think?
Bossing her around?
Yeah, I let her do what she wants. I think maybe I ought to give her cooked meals at certain hours. What do you think? I don't have any clock. You know, I never know what time it is. You think she'd eat them?
I don't know. You know her better than anybody.
I give her a head. I let her do what she wants to do. I think it's awful. She should eat, you know, chopped meat and a baked potato at a certain hour for lunch. Then have a nice little dinner. But that takes timing. No, I'm not ready, and I have no makeup on. But things are getting better. Did you find my son in bathtub?
Right. I couldn't believe it.
Come on in. We're not ready.
Is that Al down there?
Yeah.
Hello, Al.
Hi.
Ben, oh God, almost broke my neck then. God, he's dead again. Oh. How could Edie leave these things like this? Come on, mommy, coming down these stairs. Hmm?
No, I'm afraid.
Don't I? I feel funny. I feel funny.
No. It's like a night at the opera.
Is it? The night at the opera will be when I get in that chair in the dining room. That will be the night at the opera.
Mama, Lois and Jack are here.
Hello, Jack. Happy birthday.
Larry Poole wanted me to go.
I say, thank you. Where's the cushion, Edie? Get the cushion out.
Oh, yes.
What's in here? Oh, God. And those chairs.
So now I'm bringing up.
Are they dirty, those chairs? Hello, Jack. Well, you're very cute to celebrate with me today.
But I like you in that costume, Lois.
My dear.
But see, Edie hasn't done it. You better not sit in those chairs. They look very dirty.
No. Here, they can sit on paper.
I thought you were going to clean up, Edie.
I tried. I swept the...
Well, I'm kind of disappointed. Jack, you don't mind sitting by me, do you?
I swept the floor.
We have wine. I'll bring down the glasses.
Bring down the wine, please. And Edie's too, Lois is too ginger ale. But don't let the cats out.
How do you like the thing Lois did for me, Jack? Are your eyes good enough to see that?
Oh, sure.
How are your eyes?
She's no waitress, I'll tell you.
Well, she's got a pretty heavy
chair. He's a trainee, won't you? Oh, no, she's not going to. She's going to do just as you want, you know.
She's a trash waitress. They always do just as they want.
It's your mother. May she live to be at least 80.
No, it's one more year. Ha, ha, ha.
She's in her 79. She's in her 79. Yeah, 79.
She's going to tell that to everybody in East Hampton, you know.
That's right.
Everybody's going to know my age.
Happy birthday.
Thank you very much.
Sing the happy birthday.
Sing it. Come on, you can do it again. Happy birthday to you.
Good.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Why do we have to have paper cups when I wanted my green goblets with all the gold on them, and she wouldn't bring them down. So disappointed on my birthday. Oh, what a beautiful! I knew I wanted to look at that cake. Did you ever see anything like that? Happy birthday! Gorgeous! Imagine having red.
That's terrific.
Somebody's calling me, Edie. My sister ordered that. I'm sorry, I called.
Yeah. Hey, Mama, can you move your chair a little bit?
Yeah.
This is the first time we used the lawn wire in the dining room.
Oh. Hello, Polly. Thank you, dear. Are you going to sing it all the way through?
Wow.
Listen, I got your beautiful present. Edie, have you brought the present down yet?
Yeah, we're going to open it.
We're sitting down here in the so-called old... What, dear?
We haven't opened any presents yet.
Didn't you? It's a great big box up there.
Tremendous box. We have no presents.
Well, you sent me a card. I got that.
I don't think she did send one. Be show and show us the poet.
Now, I haven't started the cake, but I'll read you what it says. It says, what does it say, Jack? Edith?
Happy birthday, Edith.
Oh, it says, happy birthday, Edith. And that's all in red.
Yes.
And then the flowers underneath are, yellow flowers with green. It's perfectly enormous cake. Oh, thank you, dear.
Yeah.
Take a box. That's the girl you hated.
Take a box?
Yeah.
Are they both having eye trouble? They freeze your eyes now.
Both of them had
operations.
They both had two operations.
And then they weren't good either.
One lost her eye, one good.
Yeah, Muriel's eyes disappeared, dried out, disappeared.
No,
I
saw her.
Vision.
No, she's all right. She's cured.
Oh, the cataract.
Absolutely cured, Edie.
Well.
She's cured now.
Did she say she was cured?
Yeah, she said her eyes perfectly wonderful.
The really nice thing to have is get deaf and get blind and then have some cancer come in your face and your lips.
Cancer.
Cancer.
On your lips.
You don't have that.
Go blind
and
be deaf.
Well, cancer is worse.
Yeah.
Yes.
You want to open my little presents and then
yeah, I am.
Edie, did you ever see anything as cute as this?
A little pad there to write your request on.
You know, I need that more than anything to write things down. I have my things written all over boxes, all over the bed, everywhere. I got Epstein's. Address, I got, who have I got, baby? All the electricians in East Hampton. All of them. Isn't that nice, Brookie? Look.
Terrific.
I can't be late now, and I can't forget, and I can't hate anybody, and I can't do anything. This little book is going to keep me straight. Straight as a die. Isn't that nice when I haven't had a little thing like that in ages?
I had a wonder. Your hands are cold. It did you no good, my food.
Oh, no.
Your hands are cold, lady.
Well, I must be on my course, I guess. Well, so long, folks.
Thank you for your card and your ice cream. I love you very much.
That's your ice cream.
Where's my yellow cushion, baby?
Yeah.
It's happening, baby, you know it?
Turn the heat off, it's terribly hot in here.
Your room's terribly dirty, it's got to be clean.
Not tonight, Geraldine.
It's smell, I can hardly sit here.
I love that smell, I thrive on it. Makes me feel good.
We have to hang the portrait and clean the room.
No, pull the chair out, he wants to look at it. I'm not ashamed of anything. Well, my body is a very precious place. It's concentrated ground.
Consecrated.
What are you doing?
Take a picture of me.
I'm trying to think of what I know what I could have. Oh, for goodness sakes, he is my God. They seem as, you know, you don't seem as I see myself, but you're very good what you do see me as. I mean, it's okay.
Are you pleased with those pictures?
You know, I see myself as a little girl. And all that.
I see you as a very immature child.
You know, she sees me as a baby and I see myself some kind of a little girl. They see me as a woman. I don't see them. But when I get out of here, I do. When I go to New York City, I see myself as a woman. But in here, I'm just, you know, mother's little daughter.
I doubt that very much.
You want to play out of the record I bought you?
Virginia Military Institute. My God, I can't get over this. I really can't.
And you can't dance at all.
Why can't
I? I never saw you do anything military. Remember?
Why, you're absolutely crazy. There isn't anything I can't do.
David.
me before this.
Well, then you had your mother.
Yeah.
But they're more interested.
Good Lord. I can't believe it. It's 140 bong.
Here, Kitty, I got a big, nice piece of white. Here, Kitty. Here. Hey, Kitty. You like that? That's nice. Yeah. No bones in that one. Well, that's a pretty song, Don't Throw Bouquets at Me. You know, that was, I was trying to think of the words of that.
Bouquet.
No, don't throw bouquets at me.
Don't.
Don't what? Hurry up. Don't what?
Your lips.
Oh, no, that's not it. No, you're way off the beat there. No. Dad, go to the bottom of the class. No, that isn't there.
Do mine.
No. No, that isn't it.
People will say we're in the law.
You didn't say love. You're not Czechoslovakian. Love. Mm-hmm. You don't say love. Mm-hmm. You say that. You see, she knows she sings so badly that she had to wiggle about 20 times to every note, you see, to distract the people, you know, that you really can't sing a drop.
I can sing like mad.
Well, sing beautifully. You're singing incorrectly. Very ugly. Always must do everything correctly. Now start at the top now.
Don't throw bouquets at me.
Don't make funny faces.
My.
Now that's what I want, the next line.
Ah, much too much.
Oh no, you're way off there. No, that's not it.
What are he?
No, he doesn't make up a lot of words you can't remember. No, oh, don't do that. Oh, me singing can love. Where in the hell did you come from? Wrong kind of bed.
Okay.
I love you very much, both of you. But you know, you see, he took my pillow and I'm in agony. Why'd you lose my pillow, Edie?
Warm inside, so I can sleep. And then I want to weep. I'm a getting tired. So I can do. Lily Marlene, down around the lamp post in something.
La da da dee da
da dee da 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 da. If I only knew the words, Marlene Dietrich. Down around the lamp post. It's Lily Marlene. That's an old war song, Mother. I tried to get you. I called and called and called.
Oh, yeah?
I guess you went out.
How's everything?
Then I called again. You were busy.
What's
guess what's happening?
What?
What I felt was in the cards, you know, and I'm telling you, I'm not going to spend another 10 years with this. And I spent 10 years with the last.
You mean Tom Logan?
What is it now?
The marble floor is moving in.
Who is?
The marble floor.
Jerry.
Oh.
He just gave us a washing machine. That cements the deal. I gotta spend the rest of my life washing clothes and that goddamn.
Don't blame her.
It's a very nice washing machine. It came from this house they're gonna sell. You know, he had a job as a gardener's assistant at this house.
And they're going to sell the house, so they gave him the washing machine. But he's moving in. I can't watch him, I'm telling you. Of course, he's still going to have the gardening job, you know. But I think he gets home at 4 o'clock. So Mother says, do you want to come in and speak to Mother? She'd like to speak to you. Come on in. I'm pulverized by this latest thing.
Well, you do. A beautiful face like a girl. Like you look like my mother. Absolute image of my mother, Jerry. Jerry, you're not going to drink anything, are you?
No.
What are you going to have?
I'll wait for the chicken.
You're waiting for the chicken? You mean to say you're not going to have soup or a drink or highball or something like that? You think we better have some rum? No, she didn't put any papers on that thing today. I asked her to. Jerry, I'm badly treated all along.
I think my days at Grey Gardens are limited.
An extra knife. I'll put it in the middle. I forgot the
pool. You want to get my slippers, Edie? Get my slippers, will you please? You know where you put them. Have to get very tough with Edie. She won't do anything till you get very, very tough. Strong hand, says the priest.
Said she needs a strong hand. I said, Father, I know it.
I brought Edie up without her father. It was very difficult. Then she went to New York and did what she wanted to do. You know, I wanted to get Mr. Beale back and have him come back. She said she'd leave the house forever if I had a father come back.
Well, the moon is high, the breeze.
Will you bring my little radio? Edie, will you bring my little radio? It's on my bed.
Yeah.
Will you bring my little radio, please? I've got to have some professional music. She found the slippers quite remarkable. I'm getting some more. You got the radio, Edie? Got my radio? It's on the bed. How'd you have to find it so quickly? Put this up there, will you, please? Put that up there.
Listen.
All right, if you want to stay there and eat, I'll eat here.
Now
I'm going to quit that terrible racket of eating.
And I'm in a log with you. She's always hated Maureen Dixon.
Oh, I can't stand
it. Absolutely loathe Maureen Dixon.
Makes me very ill. I can't take it, Edie. I'll go right into the room and I won't have any hot food or anything. Don't do it, Edie. I'll get so mad. Listen, will you stop me? I'm going to
sing it in America.
I'll never see you again.
I'm singing it in America.
I don't care. You're not going to sing that song. Stop it, will you?
Why not?
Because I don't want to hear it. I'm your mother. Remember me?
I stripped for yours all we see.
Come on. Well, my voice is beautiful and trained. Mm-hmm. It was beautifully trained, my voice. I never tried to attract men with it. Mm-hmm.
The scene is sad.
Edie, stop it. I'm going to get up. Now, goodbye.
With
going
you.
Right in the other room with the cats where I'll be happy. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to take it. I hope my bathing suit falls off. Mm-hmm. I hope it does. Something fell off just then. Get out of here. You don't make me mad. Get out. You're making me very angry. Oh, go out. Go away. Stop that.
Yeah, but they're
going to stop it. Right. Stop that silly nonsense. Quit it.
I can't have any fun.
Go away. You had enough fun all your life.
I never had a minute's fun. Not a minute. I never had a
minute's
fun.
Go away. You don't look it. Well, you made a rotten breakfast. Horrible. You spoiled the whole thing. I can't go over to my seat now.
Mother, do you realize...
There's no back to this bathing suit.
We won't, though.
Mother, do you realize that your whole chest was showing and not moving?
Yeah, horrible, bad, everything is perfectly disgusting on account of you. You did it. You sure do bring out the worst in your mother.
I think Mother's very mean to me.
Yeah, I stopped you. Thank God I have little kids here.
Yeah, but I do several versions of that.
A beautiful voice, but you never heard it. Never heard a voice. She can really sing it decently. Sing very well. Better voice than I have. But not that song.
Yeah,
I sing Only a Rose now, Edie. You ought to be able to do that. Go on, sing it.
Only a Rose. Only a Rose. Another day. Only a Rose. I give you only a Rose.
Dying away.
Dying away. Only a Rose.
To keep an arm.
To keep only.
I don't think there's any point in my meeting anybody that doesn't like music. Do you, Mother? Because I can't stand them. Finally, I can't stand them. There's something lacking, and it's music, isn't it? I mean, a man.
Well, it's nice to have a man can play the piano for you.
Oh, no, that isn't all. She doesn't get it.
Then you can practice.
Unless the man understands music, there's no point in my even meeting him, because I never could figure out what was wrong. You know, the stockbrokers and tennis players. And I tell you who was a songwriter and a dancer and a playwright and everything. Eugene Tiskevich, but Mother got rid of him in 15 minutes.
You didn't even try his cooking. He made a poison. Might have poisoned you the first night. Do you want to marry a stranger?
Very decent guy. I looked up his horoscope.
Want to marry a stranger?
He was born November the 14th.
I have to go in now. Okay.
Very wonderful boy. Too young for me, probably.
Who
32.
Is this?
Eugene Tiskevich.
I couldn't stand having another cook in this
that
house.
That isn't the point. I actually proposed under the window.
He had no home. He was living in a third-class hotel.
Under the window.
You know,
he said, Edith, if you want to get married, I'll marry you. And I think that was decent. Don't you?
I don't see why.
Probably wouldn't happen. Just the same. Not one person had entered Grey Gardens for many years before Eugene Tiskevich came around. So I credit him with all the nerve in the world.
Why would he even Jewish. People that walked one of the Maidstone Club with me years.
Don't believe it.
Don't believe a word of it, kid. Not a word.
Edie, if your father could hear you, he'd turn in his grave. He'd say, my God, Edie.
Well, anyway, I think you were very cruel, Mother.
Well,
he had one of the best families in Poland. And he was related to the Obolenskis, and I think it's terrible.
Everybody.
Give me a chance with
Eugene. Just gave it, Johnny. That was absolutely cruel.
Well, he's
Friday.
Very
only
cool.
Away.
You want to marry me?
I don't care. I was the only one besides these horrible people that came around
have
here.
Have you got your thing lighted for that?
Well,
he was only 32 and from the very
beginning. 32 and she got
rid of him in 15 minutes flat.
No, he didn't. He said
and
no.
I bored with all these old people like Jerry and all those people.
That wasn't the truth.
No.
That was not the truth. He said, how could such a warm, lovely person over the telephone turn into anything so cold? That's what he said right down on the floor. So I said, you better go home. Never say goodbye to me. How could such a warm, lovely woman over the telephone turn into something so cold? I thought that was just a little too much.
I tell you the whole thing. You might as well face it. It's my mother's house, and she owns it, and she wanted the people she wanted in it, and she didn't want the people that I wanted in it. But God knows whom I wanted in it. I mean, besides Eugene. And Mother wouldn't allow Eugene to stay even 15 minutes. But I had to spend 10 years with Tom Logan. And now we have Jerry, who is Mother's friend. So you just can't do anything about it.
So I can see now why girls get married. You know, they're forced into it. It's all a question of who you want to stay with. Of course, I'm mad about animals, but raccoons and cats become a little bit boring. I mean, for too long a time. I don't know. I better check on Mother and the cats. She's a lot of fun. I hope she doesn't die. I hate to spend the winter here, though. Oh, God. Another winter.
Any little rat's nest in New York, any little mouse hole, any little rat hole, even on 10th Avenue, I would like better.
Thank you. were trying to get me. I called up the telephone company after I got your letter, and I tried to find out, you know, why they didn't ring this bell, phone.
When I called, they didn't know anything about it, so I called
AT&T also. Yeah. I tell you, the trouble with this phone, when it rings, I can't hear the ring, and so I can't answer it. That's the trouble. Listen, how are you?
I'm fine. I wonder how you are.
I'm okay.
Good. Everything okay?
Al, darling, could you send me something?
Sure. What is it?
Send me some large safety pins. I just have little ones. Could you send me large safety, not too large, you know, but you, large safety.
You mean about an inch or an inch and a half, right? Something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, about an inch or an inch and a half, something like that?
What?
Maybe an inch or an inch and a half long.
I can't hear you. Yeah. Isn't that awful?
Yeah.
Listen.
Go ahead.
How's your family? How is everything?
Everybody's fine.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, very fine.
You said you'd write me a letter. Thank you for your Christmas card.
Oh, yeah, sure. And thanks for all of your letters.
It's a beautiful card.
Yeah.
Listen, the election, the voting was so terrible down here. It ruined the Christmas. All the trouble about the election.
I know. And Edie, it's terrible. It's terrible.
Listen, Al.
Yeah.
Do you think that Al Gore is going to get in 4 years, or do you think it's all over?
No, I think he has a much better chance.
Might.
Yeah. I mean, after all, he really won this election.
Oh, that's good.
You know, he really won it.
Listen, you know, I'm not a Republican. I was never a Republican.
Of course.
No, of course. I was always a Democrat.
Of course, me too.
Listen, Al, sweetheart.
Yeah.
I would never hurt your feelings about anything.
Well, I'm sure you would.
I wouldn't.
Of course. And I feel the same about you.
Oh, you're so cute.
Yeah.
Well, listen, I think it's a shame, Al, that I never married you. I mean, I'm very upset that Jillian got such a good husband and three such divine children. And I just should have grabbed you, Al. Well, listen, sweetheart, I guess I'll just have to get over it.
But, you know, one of these days, I don't know just when, I'm doing so many things. One of these days, I'd love to come down and see you, but I'll call you ahead of time.
Oh, yes, you must come.
Okay.
You must come because you might die, somebody might shoot you or something. So I just have to see you before.
Yeah, of course.
Well, just write me a letter.
Okay, I'll write you a letter.
Darling Al, I guess I've been in love with you for 30 years, but I just didn't know it. Please forgive me.
Oh, Edie.
Please forgive me, Al.
Edie, you know, there's hardly a day that goes by that somebody doesn't say, oh, that Edie, where is she? What's going on? I love that film. I love those two women. Every day there's somebody that says that. I mean, it's... Two things, Edie. One is they adore you and your mother, and they adore the film.
They feel so
privileged to.
Now I do get letters from fans. I do have people that call me up and people that write me letters about Grey Gardens.
Oh
they,
yeah.
They say they keep going to see it.
Yeah. Oh yes. Did I tell you, I met a woman who had seen the film 120 times.
Darling Al.
And she has...
Please take care of yourself.
I will. You too.
I'll write you a letter.
Okay, please do.
All right, sweetheart.
Okay, love to you.
Love you,